Throughout the 1960s and 70s, there were four major legacy carriers that do not exist today. There was Howard Hughes' legendary Transport Airlines, or TWA. Pan Am at the time was flying their Boeing 707 Clippers across the Atlantic, also known as the Pond, and then Eastern Airlines had their Lockheed L-1011s. But there was one airline in particular that completely soared above the rest and has no modern day equivalent. I am of course talking about the vibrant Braniff International Airways. Throughout the mid to late 1960s and into the 1970s, Braniff International Airways was an expanding airline that was always trying to get those new passenger ticket sales. Braniff destinations included places throughout North America as well as Central and South America too. But the thing that set Braniff far apart from its competitors was of course the vibrant colors that they painted all of their airliners. Did I mention that Braniff completely set itself apart from the competition by having some of the best in-flight catering out of the entire airline services? Now, Braniff was a truly original airline that was always trying to come up with new and original ideas.
It was the 3rd of September, that day I'll always remember, yes I will, cause there was a day that my daddy died.
So of course, when the supersonic Concorde came out over in Europe, Braniff wanted one of their own. However, there are a couple of Achilles heels to Braniff's idea of leasing Concorde from both British Airways and Air France. First, because they leased the airplanes and they didn't buy them, they couldn't actually paint them in their original orange colors. Second, because they were flying the Concorde over the continental United States and not over international waters, they couldn't break the speed of sound. Mathematically, this caused a problem. You see, most airliners can fly at 0.8 to 0.85 Mach, which is around 533 knots. To do 0.95 Mach on the Concorde meant they were doing about 633 knots. That's about a 100 knot difference, or about 115 miles per hour. The failure of the Braniff Concorde, along with some other crazy original ideas in the late 1970s, eventually led to Braniff's bankruptcy in 1982. Sadly, Braniff International Airways is now a distant memory of the past, although if you're a regular South Park episode watcher, you've probably seen the Braniff tagline at the end of their shows.